Welcome to Grand Sensei Dareth's Mojo Dojo. I am Grand Sensei Dareth, and I dareth you to join my dojo.
Grand Sensei Dareth, aka the
Brown Ninja,
was a self-proclaimed master of the martial arts, even though he often made mistakes that endangered himself and his friends. However, Dareth was still a man with a big heart, as he risked his life multiple times to save people in need. Even with his clumsy behavior, the ninjas still count on him for aid and see him as a friend. Also, we all know he's just acting like an idiot to fool everyone of his true omnipotent power. But with that out of the way, I present to you the complete history of Dareth. While growing up, Dareth's mother used to make him puffy pot stickers, which was his favorite dish. Before becoming a sensei, Dareth toured Ninjago with a show called Brown Suede Shoes. He even lost a few talent shows to Cole's father, Lou. Dareth always wanted to be a guitarist, but due to not having an instrument to play with, he mastered the art of air guitar. While the ninja were looking for a suitable place to train Lloyd, they entered Grand Sensei Dareth's Mojo Dojo and met the man himself. Dareth told the ninja that if they could beat him in a battle, Lloyd can train in his dojo. Kai quickly performed spinjitzu on Dareth, convincing him to allow the ninja to train in his dojo. Later, he tried to prove that he was stronger than Lloyd by attempting to break 50 planks with his fist. Dareth said that if he succeeded, the ninja would have to include him in the group as the
Brown Ninja!
However, all he did was humiliate himself. When the pirates attacked Ninjago City, Dareth boarded their ship and tried fighting the pirates. This ended poorly, however, as he was tied up and forced to walk off the plank. Dareth was then narrowly saved by the Ultra Dragon, believing that he was the one who called it. After the attack, Dareth tried one final time to outwit the ninja, but was taken down by Jay. He then asked for forgiveness, and everyone laughed. Dareth's dojo was planned to be destroyed by Darnagam Enterprises, a fake company created by Lord Garmadon. Nia informed Dareth and the ninja about Ninja Ball Run, a racing competition that would earn enough money to save the dojo. The ninja entered the race while Dareth, Nia, and Sensei Wu watched from the bleachers. Throughout the race, Dareth became worried and shielded his eyes multiple times. He then proclaimed to the announcers that without his dojo, he would have no place to train his students. This caused the audience to start cheering for the ninja, and they won the race. Out of happiness, Dareth jumped into the trophy containing the cash prize. Dareth walked into his dojo to find the ninja training, warning them not to make a mess as he had a class later. They ignored him anyway, much to Dareth's dismay. Later, he was watching the news about the earthquakes appearing in Ninjago City when a stone warrior busted into his dojo. He told his students to run while he attacked the warrior to no effect. He later fled the scene and knocked over Gail Gossip's cameraman, becoming her new one. When the citizens of Ninjago City were forced to flee into a helipad at the top of the building, Dareth saw the flight of stairs and immediately went for the elevator. Zane advised that this was unwise and was proven right when a stone warrior appeared when the doors opened. Dareth then took the stairs but got tired quickly and rested. Getting jump-scared by a stone warrior, Dareth gained a burst of adrenaline and bolted up the stairs, knocking Misako's researching skulls out of her hand in the process. He then arrived to find the Destiny's Bounty taking everyone to safety. When the ninja declared that they would voyage the Endless Sea in search of the Island of Darkness, Dareth asked if he could defend the civilians in their absence. They sarcastically agreed and made him part of the team, telling Dareth that he had the element of hot air. He then stood on the pier and blew away the ship, claiming that he was helping the bounty's passage. While Dareth was teaching his students, General Kozu suddenly burst through the window and into the dojo. The Grand Sensei told the Stone Warrior that he messed with the wrong dojo and ordered his students to attack, watching as they completely swarmed the general. With Kozu defeated, Dareth kicked him out of his dojo and emerged just in time to witness dark clouds forming above Ninjago City. Believing this to be the ninja, Dareth cheered along with everybody else. To his dismay, the Overlord appeared instead with the Stone Army. Gathering his courage, Dareth faced the Dark Lord and told him to leave the city before he was forced to fight. In response, the Overlord aimed the Garmatron's cannons at the Brown Ninja and opened fire. Dareth barely evaded the barrage of dark matter and fled down the street as the overlord slowly corrupted Ninjago City. Somehow, Dareth managed to survive the dark matter corrupting the city and cheered when he saw Lloyd and the Golden Mech pass by his dojo to storm the overlord's new fortress. He eventually stumbled upon the Helmet of Shadows and put it on, completely unaware that he now controlled the Stone Army. Riding the Ultra Dragon to the Overlord's fortress, Dareth finally got accepted by the ninja as one of them and even got to wield Kai's elemental blade. He ordered the Stone Army to climb the fortress's exterior, but they were all shot down by a corrupted Nia. Dareth stayed down while the ninja ascended and soon witnessed Lloyd's transformation into the ultimate Spinjitzu master. He nearly got crushed by the Overlord before he was saved by the Golden Dragon. After the battle, Dareth met up with his allies and claimed that they had all played a part in the victory. After the final battle, Dareth was employed to work at Sensei Wu's newly founded Ninja Academy. However, he spent most of his time just watching television. With Ninjago City's power still knocked out, Dareth took his students to Ninjago City Aquarium for a field trip. When Pythor released the sea creatures, Dareth stopped the shark from attacking his students. After Zane sacrificed himself to defeat the Golden Master, Dareth was present at his funeral. At Master Chen's noodle house, Dareth complained to a cashier after he learned of the discontinuation of Puffy Pot stickers, his favorite food. He later chased after the noodle trucks and unexpectedly found Nia driving one of them. Dareth then climbed into the disguised DB Express and accompanied Nia to Chen's island. Once on the island, Dareth helped Nia disguise to infiltrate Chen's palace. While waiting on news of the mission, Dareth rocked out in the DBX until he accidentally triggered the speakers, alerting the Anacondrite cultists to his presence. While attempting to flee with the DBX, Dareth crashed and was caught by the guards. A captive Dareth was sent to work at Chen's noodle factory and was pleasantly surprised to see Cole and the newly rebuilt Zane there also. However, his unexpected arrival forced the prisoners to come up with a new escape plan. While everyone else planned an escape route, Dareth constructed a machine that makes Puffy Pot stickers. This act inspired the team to make a rotojet to break out. Once the machine was finished, Dareth and the other prisoners used the rotojet to escape. While the ninja went after Skylar, Dareth flirted with some of Chen's kabuki before realizing that his allies had abandoned him. He was later accidentally left behind on Chen's island after the elemental masters unlocked their elemental dragons and flew back to Ninjago City. The ninja went back for Dareth after finally noticing that he wasn't with them in their departure. On the way back to the city, Dareth reminded his friends of the oath they had taken to never leave a man behind. Dareth fought alongside his allies at the Battle of the Corridor of Elders. After the battle ended and Skylar announced that she was taking over Chen's noodle house, Dareth interrupted Kai and Skylar's kiss and begged her to bring the Puffy Pot stickers back. She agreed and Dareth left pleased. Dareth eventually gained possession of the prototype X1, but crashed it into a cement truck.
Dang it, Dareth!
After the ninja helped Dareth with his movie, he told them that with his help, they would have fans all over Ninjago. Later, he spotted the ninja behind a billboard and offered them a ride to Styx. While the ninja were imprisoned in Cryptarium, he delivered a cake with tools inside to help them escape. However, Cole ate it, somehow. Dareth later informed the ninja that Nauticon had stolen the Realm Crystal. Dareth assembled Cole, Lloyd, and Nia to brainstorm their plan of rescuing Jay, bringing in Dan and Kevin Hageman for ideas. Although Ronan was skeptical of the plan, Dareth insisted that it was their best shot and helped the ninja prepare. Dareth was recruited as part of Jay's ninja replacements team after the original ninja were trapped in the Jin Blade. Dareth attempted to fly after some sky pirates that were spying on Jay's briefing with the replacements. However, his attempt to create a dragon caused him to plummet before being saved by Ronan. While the ninja went to stop Nia's wedding, Dareth and his team returned to Ninjago City to prepare for the worst. After Jay's final wish altered the timeline, Dareth arrived at the hospital rooftop and caught Jay and Nia's kiss on camera. Dareth later became manager of the Royal Blacksmiths before their Day of the Departed concert. He He was subsequently targeted by the revived General Kozu, who sought to slay the brown ninja to take his place among the living. However, Dareth managed to find the Helmet of Shadows in the Ninjago Museum of History and turned Kozu's stone warriors against him, sending the villain back to the departed realm. After the ordeal, Dareth apologized to Dr. Saunders for destroying part of the museum. Later that night, Dareth joined the ninja at their new base in the Temple of Air Jitsu and released lanterns into the air with them. Dareth, along with Misako and Ronin, helped the ninja move their stuff into the Temple of Air Jitsu. Dareth merely supervised until Misako found Nia's Samurai X suit, grabbing his attention. The brown ninja soon donned the helmet, calling himself
Samurai D! The D is for Dareth.
Ronin was about to fight Dareth to give up the helmet, but the forward time blade landed in Ninjago, resulting in Ronin suddenly being on Dareth's back, with the latter begging for him to get off. Dareth camped out all night for the release of the Borg Watch. He was showing off all of his Borg gadgets when the Vermilion attacked. Dareth tried to fight one, but was immediately knocked down, running away and leaving the ninja to deal with the snakes. Dareth screamed with dismay after he found out that all of his fake trophies were stolen by the Vermilion. He then went to Ronin's shop to buy replacement trophies, but the two decided to go to the Temple of Air Jitsu to warn the ninja. Later, while fighting Vermilion warriors, Dareth was reminded of his stolen trophies and unlocked his God Mode, defeating multiple Vermilion and even breaking Ronin's leg in the process. Dareth bought a watering hole, later naming it Laffy's, to relive his glory days of fighting alongside the ninja. When Cole and Zane entered Laffy's while disguised, they saw it had been overtaken by the Sons of Garmadon and were surprised to see Dareth there working as a bartender. Dareth informed them of Ultraviolet and Mr. E when he was called away by one of the thugs. Following the arrest of the Sons of Garmadon, Dareth was finally able to open his bar to the public again, so the ninja decided to celebrate there. There, they heard the news of Harumi's escape, convincing Dareth to allow Misako and a toddler Wu to stay at his apartment. Disguised in a green cloak, Dareth was confronted by two Sons of Garmadon members for wearing green. Dareth tried to intimidate them by calling himself the but he was just pushed aside and had his food stolen. Dareth eventually made it back to the resistance base, but could only give a disgusting puffy pot sticker as rations. When the Sons of Garmadon found their hideout, Dareth assisted the others in the escape and found the wreckage of the Destiny's bounty. The others realized that the ninja could have survived the crash, but they were then cornered by the Sons of Garmadon. Dareth attempted to hold them off, but was scared into submission. However, he and the others were saved by the Elemental Masters, escaping the area with a newfound hope. Once the Resistance found a new hideout, the Elemental Masters began reintroducing themselves. Dareth was jump-scared by Mr. Pale suddenly becoming visible, and when Tox asked what element Dareth was the master of, he responded claiming that he was the master of Brown. Istake ordered Dareth to fight Karloff in order to train Lloyd on how to become a leader. Due to Lloyd's bad leadership skills, Dareth got beat multiple times by the Master of Metal. After the battle, Dareth apologized to Lloyd for letting him down. However, this gave Lloyd motivation to lead the Resistance and come up with a plan. Dareth later watched Lloyd's speech from the base and was proud that he got his courage back. Dareth consulted Mistake on feeling left out of the Resistance due to not having an elemental power and asked if she could make a potion to give him one. She conceded and stirred one up for him in a giant jar, telling him he has to drink the whole thing. Dareth chugged the entire drink and gained the brown power. He went to show off his newfound powers to the rest of the Resistance, but the flame faded and left him needing to use the bathroom. When he went outside, he witnessed the Sons of Garmadon surrounding the base. Dareth ran back inside to tell the Resistance about the ambush that was about to occur. When the Sons of Garmadon attacked the base, Dareth scared some bikers with his brown power, but ran outside as he needed to use the bathroom again. Dareth got on the battle wagon with Lloyd, Nia, and Skylar, but was chased down by some bikers. Dareth needed to use the bathroom again and went outside to find he unintentionally knocked down one of the Sons of Garmadon off the vehicle. His relief was short-lived, however, as the Colossus stepped on the vehicle, about to crush the people inside. Pixel then attacked Emperor Garmadon, allowing the others to escape. The remaining resistance members hid in Ninjago City's docks and tried to comfort Lloyd. When a rat approached them, Dareth tried scaring it away with a broom until it revealed itself to be Mistake. She then told the group that she could transform again after she ate. The resistance were shocked to learn that Mistake was an Oni. When the Sons of Garmadon patrolled the docks searching for Lloyd, Dareth helped ambush them. With Harumi surrounded, they took her hostage. While guarding Harumi, Dareth listened to music until he noticed that she removed her gag. Harumi made fun of his bathroom urges and told Dareth that he could have real power if he let her go. Dareth ignored her and tried putting the gag back on, but Harumi used a chair to step on his foot. With Dareth screaming in pain, Harumi escaped and tied him up. When Lloyd returned to find Dareth tied up, he asked the brown ninja what happened and where did she go. Dareth watched as Skylar was able to mimic some of Garmadon's power and control the Colossus. However, she was poisoned by the dark power. Dareth employed the others to run as the Colossus, again being controlled by Garmadon, quickly approached them. While escaping the Colossus, Dareth pointed out how Garmadon had lost his mind after Harumi's death. Nia held off Ultraviolet while the others fled for the battle wagon. The three then crashed into Ultraviolet, resulting in the destruction of the Mask of Hatred. Dareth and the others thought they won, but were then surrounded by Sons of Garmadon bikers. Dareth, Nia, and Lloyd attempted to hold off the bikers, but it was clear they were outnumbered. Fortunately, the ninja arrived and saved them, with Dareth happy to see them back. Dareth and Lloyd told Wu of Mistako's fate, but Dareth told them to keep fighting to honor her memory, handing Lloyd a katana. Wu then tasked Dareth to aid a wounded Nia and incapacitated Skylar. The brown ninja then used a battle wagon to drive into Ninjago City, coming across Gale Gossip and her cameraman being harassed by some Sons of Garmadon thugs. Dareth stepped out to save them, but slipped on a rock. This ironically took them down, and Dareth asked if that was caught on camera. Dareth was about to leave before Gossip asked for his name. He replied that he was her number one fan, leaving her fawning. After Garmadon was defeated, Dareth attended the celebration for the ninja when Nia invited him with the others. He was then cheered on as he made major contributions to the victory. While in the newly rebuilt monastery of Spinjitzu, Dareth learned Jay was practicing how to ask Nia to be his yang, much to his excitement. When they went outside, Dareth was saddened to see his absence on the mural of the ninja's past adventures. However, he did find a brown spot on the Liberation of Ninjago's mural and claimed that that was him. Suddenly, the group saw Firstborn crash land near the monastery. They saw a badly injured Faith and brought her in to heal. Dareth and several of the ninja's other allies attended the celebration being held at the monastery. He then witnessed the ninja painting their most recent mural. Dareth reopened Laffy's karaoke bar after it was closed for multiple months and returned working there. Dareth was in a commercial on the NGTV network, promoting the newly rebuilt Laffy's karaoke bar. Dareth was working at Laffy's when he saw Gil Gossip pass outside and left to follow her. Dareth greeted Zane and Pixel when they entered Laffy's, asking if this was due to the Prime Empire issue. Pixel was surprised that Dareth guessed it right, then he went to retrieve his brown ninja suit. When he came back, a fight occurred in the bar. Dareth attempted to join in, but was hit by a chair. Dareth joined a tour bus driving around Ninjago City, later asking the tour guide about the brown ninja. The guy didn't believe that colored ninja existed and told Dareth that someone was pulling his leg. Suddenly, a giant tsunami flooded the city. Dareth got the tourist to the lower half of the bus and attempted to steer the vehicle while it was underwater. Some debris crashed into the bus, flooding the inside. Dareth told everyone to hold their breath while he attempted to open the door. The bus was nearly filled with water when Jay arrived and got the door open, helping the people escape. Dareth, however, was hit by some debris, being swept away in the current. Fortunately, Nia saved him at the last moment, greeting him with surprise when she found out it was Dareth. The brown ninja was ecstatic to learn that the ninja still remembered he existed. Dareth later fled to the Destiny's Bounty with the other civilians to escape the flood. After Nia's sacrifice, Dareth attended her memorial to pay respect to his friend. After receiving a bunch of parking tickets and committing other misdemeanors, Dareth hired a lawyer to remove all the charges. This act inspired the Brown Ninja to become a lawyer himself. Dareth was on a bus while the old ninja and the new ninja were fighting over Asphira's staff in an armored truck being carried by Zane. The flying truck almost hit the bus that Dareth was in. Dareth was hired by the ninja to defend them in court. After the very fast trial, Kai was angry at Dareth for allowing the judge to convict them as guilty. The lawyer then explained that he only had 3 weeks of law class and attempted to remind the judge of all the times that the ninja had saved the city. The judge acknowledged this, and instead of giving the ninja a life sentence, he sentenced them to 5 years in Kryptarian prison. Dareth tried to convince the judge to give them a less harsh punishment, but he was ignored. Later, Dareth went to the monastery, stressed on finding a solution to the ninja's imprisonment. Dareth and Skylar visited Kryptarium via a taxicab. They were almost denied access before Dareth showed his attorney license. While speaking with the ninja, Dareth informed them of his attempts to free them using a mistrial, not knowing how one actually works. Before leaving, Dareth told them of one last strategy he had to offer. Dareth, disguised as an old man, intercepted a prison transport holding the ninja and pretended his car was having a breakdown. This distraction allowed Nia, now Samurai X again, to rescue the ninja and escape. They were then pursued by a police car, but Dareth managed to get it turned over by a giant rock before the engine failed. This forced the group to split up and meet back at Twitchy Tim's gas station, with Dareth going with Kai and Zane. Dareth, Kai, and Zane trek through the desert before hitchhiking with Sally. Sally told them of her dream to be a singer in Ninjago City and turned her song on. Dareth and Kai were both impressed until Hound Dog McBrog found the van and chased it, even after it fell in a ravine. After losing the marshal, Zane convinced Sally to return to her parents after seeing that she missed them. When the four arrived at her house, Dareth told Sally to not give up on her dreams before leaving with Kai and Zane. Dareth, Kai, and Zane eventually arrived at Twitchy Tim's gas station shortly before they met up with the other ninja. While the ninja were discussing their plan to infiltrate the Council of the Crystal King, they were ambushed by Hound Dog McBrog and the police. However, due to Fugidove's distraction, Dareth and the ninja were able to escape using one of the police trucks. Now in Ninjago City, the ninja dropped off Dareth. During the battle with the Crystal Army, Dareth joined along with many members of the Resistance to help take down the warriors. The appearance of the ninja's allies allowed them to unlock dragon form, weakening the Crystal soldiers. With the warriors now weakened, Dareth was able to take down many of them. After the defeat of the Overlord, Dareth celebrated with the other allies of the ninja in the streets of Ninjago City. Later, Dareth visited the monastery which was currently being rebuilt by the ninja. Kai asked what he was doing there, to which Dareth replied that he brought some friends to help rebuild their home. While in the monastery, Dareth jump-scared Kai and Skylar as they were about to kiss, probably to discuss something about puffy pot stickers. Hey, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's Ninjago character history video, but don't let this distract you from the fact that Dareth is an actual god, okay? But in all seriousness, make sure to leave down in the comments what character you would like to see me go over next time. And remember, never put off until tomorrow what can be done today. Have a good one.